everyone. This week we've been learning about the system of our body that includes our bones. Do you remember the name of this system? It's called the skeletal system. That's right. Today we're going to learn the names of some of the bigger sets of bones in your body. We'll be completing a book called The Human Skeleton. Okay, so first let's look at this page. And you should have one of these, so you can point along and look at these with me as we go. Let me focus you a little bit better there. There we go. So we'll start with this one. This is the one up here on top of your head, and it protects your brain. Do you know the name of that large bone? Skull. That's your skull, and you can see that word right here, skull. Okay, how about this one? Protects your spinal column. It's your spine. That's a bunch of bones stacked together there. Okay, your spine. These bones here protect your lungs. Rib cage. And your lungs are in there, and those protect your lungs. This is the big bone up here. Put your hand on this one. This is your, from your shoulder down to your elbow. It's called your humerus. Let's say that together. Humerus. Humerus. This is your humerus. You have two. Okay. And then feel the bone. Feel this bone. It goes from your hip down to your knee. So feel that one. That is your femur. That's the largest bone in your body, very big bone, your femur. And then over here to this butterfly looking bone, that's your pelvis. And that's like where your hips come. That's where your femur comes up here and connects in here. And that's like where your hips are, your pelvis in the center of your body, your spine, you can see, comes down into your pelvis also. Okay, and you know what? We didn't do this, but feel along, feel your backbone. That's another word for spine. If you bend over a little bit, you can feel all those bumps along your backbone. That's your spine, okay? So remember the name of this one? Skull, spine, rib cage, or we can say ribs, humerus, femur, pelvis. Okay, so now we're going to make a book and we're going to include these bones in our book. There's two different versions of this book. Some of you have a book that has some blank lines in it, and I want you to write the words of the names of those bones. And some of you have a book that already has the words written for you. So let's look at this one first, and then I'll look at the other one. So if you have the one with the line on it, you're just going to have to be patient for a minute while I work with my friends who have the words already in their book. So everyone can do this first step, which is put your name on your book. Okay, so put your name on your book. The Human Skeleton by Becky. And then let's do the first page together, okay? My first page is humerus. So if yours is not humerus, why don't you find the page for humerus? It starts with an H. Humerus. So I see this word here, humerus. Now you're going to want to find the skeleton here with humerus. Starts with an H. So I'm looking for one that starts with an H. Here it is, humerus. Up, and I see what bone it is. Look up here. It's that bone between your shoulder and your elbow. So then you want to come back over to this one and color it in. Now I'm using a regular pencil, but you can use a colored pencil if you like to, that would be nice. But I use this one in case I needed to erase. But you make a choice of what you'd like to use. You could even use a crayon if you have a crayon that's pointy enough. So then you want to color in your humerus on both sides of your skeleton. Okay, so that's the first page. And then you're gonna do that same thing on each page of your book. So you're going to flip the page Okay. And look at this word. This says femur. So then you need to find your skeleton that says femur underneath it. See, it starts with an F and then an E. So look for that one. Femur. Here it is. And then you're going to color in your femur bones in your book. And you're going to do that for every page of your skeleton book. Okay. So you'll have a page for each of these that we looked at. So on each page, find the skeleton on your paper and then color that in your book. Okay. So this one says skull. So you'll find skull and then you'll color it in your book. Okay. So go ahead. If you have this version of the book, you can go ahead and get started. Okay. My friends who have these pages. Now, if you don't have the words written in your book, you have a blank line. You are going to, let me arrange this a little bit better so you can see. You're going to create one page for each of these skeletons. So you can decide whichever one you want to do first. I'm just going to go in order. So I'm going to do skull first. So I have to write that word skull at the bottom. So S-K-U-L-L. So write the word here, then look up. Oh, I need to color in the skull. So then you'll come back over and color in the skull. Again, I'm using a regular pencil, but you're welcome to use a colored pencil or a pointy crayon if you want to add some color and make this book really vibrant. Okay, skull. So now you can look at my book and you'll see on this page, here's the skull. Okay, and then you'll flip the page. And I might even just like put an X on this so I know I already did that one, especially if you're not going in the order that things are here. Then you'll turn to your next page. Pick another one to do. Write the word under here. So like if I was doing spine, I would write spine. Then look here to see what to color in and then color that in your book. Okay, and you'll do that for each of the pages. Write the word and color the bones. Okay, go ahead. I think that everyone should have an idea of what to do. If you need a refresher, you might want to rewind the video a little bit to see. But go ahead and get to work on this. Have fun, everyone.